your punishment, both now and in eternity. But I am truly sorry for my sins, and trusting in my Savior, Jesus Christ, I pray, Lord, have mercy on me, a sinner. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. In his great mercy, God made us alive in Christ, even when we were dead in our sins. Hear the word of Christ through his called servant. I forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Sing to the Lord a new song, Alleluia, for he has revealed his righteousness in the sight of the nations, Alleluia.
His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. He has
Lord, hear me, and let me sing.
minds of your faithful to be of one will. Grant that we may love what you have commanded and desire what you promise, that among the many changes of this world, our hearts may be fixed where true joys are found. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The first lesson for the fifth Sunday of Easter is written in the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 12. In that day you will say, I will praise you, O Lord. Although you were angry with me, your anger has turned away, and you have comforted me. Surely God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. In that day you will say, give thanks to the Lord. Call on his name. Make known among the nations what he has done, and proclaim that his name is exalted. Sing to the Lord, for he has done glorious things. Let this be known to all the world. Shout aloud and sing for joy, people of Zion, for great is the Holy One of Israel among you. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The second lesson is written in the letter of St. James, chapter 1. Don't be deceived, my dear brothers. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. He chose to give us birth through the word of truth, that we might be a kind of first fruits of all he created. My dear brothers, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. For man's anger does not bring about the righteous life that God desires. Therefore, get rid of all moral filth and the evil that is so prevalent, and humbly accept the word planted in you, which can save you. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
He will convict the world of guilt in regard to sin,
and righteousness and judgment. In regard to sin, because men do not believe in me. In regard to righteousness, because I am going to the Father, where you can see me no longer. And in regard to judgment, because the prince of this world now stands condemned. I have much more to say to you, more than you can now bear. But when he, the Spirit of truth, comes, he will guide you into all truth. He will not speak on his own, he will speak only what he hears, and he will tell you what is yet to come. He will bring glory to me by taking from what is mine and making it known to you. All that belongs to the Father is mine. That is why I said the Spirit will take from what is mine and make it known to you. This is the Gospel of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. In the name of Jesus. There is nothing more sacred today in our world than individual feelings. When someone says, well, that's just the way I feel, it seems it is everyone's duty to validate and affirm those feelings. Likewise, your thoughts, affections, and desires. They are, so we are told, outside of your control, and they must be respected. So someone sings, I can't help falling in love. Or they sing, nothing on earth can interfere when love is what the heart wants. For the heart wants what the heart wants. And so if all these feelings, affections, desires are all equally valid, to even suggest that someone's affections might be wrong or disordered, to suggest that they should be perhaps changed, is cultural heresy. In fact, to do that in some formal way may even be illegal before too long. But that is exactly what you and I prayed for this morning in the collect for the day. And it is exactly what Jesus promises in the gospel. We pray, grant that we may love what you have commanded and desire what you promise, that among the many changes of this world, our hearts may be fixed where true joys are found. In other words, make us to love and desire what is right and good. Change our minds. Determine our desires. Order our affections. Fix our hearts. When we hear Jesus' words in the gospel today, it is as though he's already heard our prayer. But of course, Christians have been praying this prayer for some 1,300 years. In answer to our prayer, Jesus sends the Holy Spirit. Just after he departed from his disciples and ascended into heaven, and the Holy Spirit delivers the word of Jesus to the world. And by that word, he changes hearts to believe this word. And yet the Holy Spirit also has something to say to the whole world, to you, and also to even those who don't believe. Because the truth is the truth, whether you believe it or not. This true word of God convicts the world. It calls it out, tries it, judges it, and declares it guilty. It does what is the most politically incorrect thing, it corrects. It rebukes. It says to the world, you are wrong. That includes feelings and thoughts and affections and desires. Those can be wrong too. It was before the flood that God looked down on earth and he said, every inclination of the thoughts of their hearts was only evil all the time. And by nature, yours are too. God, through his Holy Spirit, then reveals just how depraved you actually are. Not all our feelings are to be affirmed. Not all our desires should be fulfilled. Not all our thoughts should be validated. By nature, our thoughts, desires, and affections are false. By default. Unless they are put to proper order by these two things. What God commands and what God promises. In other words, law and gospel. Everything outside of that is out of order. But this, the commands and the promises of God, that is exactly what Jesus gives by his Holy Spirit. That's why he sends him. Jesus says, he will guide you into all truth. He will speak what he hears. He will take from what is mine and make it known to you. By that truth, God orders our affections. He does that primarily by taking the righteousness of Jesus, all of his rightly ordered desires and affections, his love for God's commands, his desire for God's promises, and making those known to you. Giving them to you. Another way to say it is that the Holy Spirit grants repentance to drown your old Adam with all its sin and evil desires, to create in you a new heart, to give you the heart of Jesus with the blood of Jesus pumping through your veins. And so we pray for you. Pray that God would order our affections, change our thoughts. And we pray that God would do this for us together. Oh God, you make the minds of your faithful to be of one will, to want the same. Now that doesn't make us all like lemmings or cloned robots with no will or individuality of your own. You are blessedly unique. But your thoughts and your feelings are not good simply because you happen to have them. Rather, every good and perfect gift comes from above. That it is good if God gives it. If you desire what God has promised, that is good. Shall we use music as an example today? There's cantate, sing. People tend to have very strong opinions about music, and music tends to stir up the affections and the feelings. So what can you say? The Word of God actually commands mankind to sing. The command of God, sing to the Lord, for he has done glorious things. We heard it several times from the prophet Isaiah. That's an imperative, a command, not an optional suggestion. Yet some might say, well, I don't really like to sing, or you don't really want to hear me sing. Or we might express our feelings about certain kinds of music. Well, I don't like that, but I really do like that. Now, if you and your desires, thoughts, affections reign supreme, then they are valid just because you feel them, then that's it. There's no more we can say. We can just ignore what God says, skip it, and try to accommodate your taste, and we'll only sing the songs and hymns that you like. Or we pray, teach us. Oh God, teach us to love what you command. And I pray that God would order our affections by his Spirit. That he would give me a heart that cannot help but sing praises to my Jesus for the glorious things he's done for me. Pray that he might take my voice and let me sing always only for my King. And even if my voice is not that sweet or my ability is weak, then pray that I might be lifted up and carried by the voices of others. Let me learn to hear the convicting voice of the Spirit in the words and the sweet sound of Jesus' promises in the songs and the hymns that we sing, and to desire those promises and love these songs for that reason. Dear Christian, one and all, rejoice. Rejoice in what your Jesus has promised you. Rejoice in the truth, in the forgiveness of sins, in your baptism, in your Holy Communion. Rejoice, even if you don't feel like it, for your feelings may change. Sometimes they should. Your Heavenly Father does not like shifting shadows. No, you have something better, something more certain, something stronger, something sure, something eternal and good. Peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. We now join in confessing the Christian faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty.
Amen.
Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. O Father of lights, every good and perfect gift comes down from your gracious hand. Remember your children and bless our heritage. Fill us with your Spirit of truth, that we would be clothed in the holiness and righteousness of Christ, who alone is our salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Father of lights, your Son has promised that the gates of Hades shall not prevail against this church, and has charged us to love our enemies and pray for them. Therefore, we earnestly implore you to remember in mercy the enemies of your church, that they would be made to hear your word of truth and be led to true repentance and faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Father of lights, all the earth worships you and sings praises to you. Kindle the fire of your love in all those who make music to you. Cause them to beautify the world and spurn the works of darkness. Bless especially all those who make music, sing, plant, tend, and beautify this holy house of prayer. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Father of lights, creator of all, we thank you this day for the birth of Grifton, as you have added him to the holy family, the human family, so also unite him to your holy church through the holy waters of baptism. By the gracious working of your Holy Spirit, help him to grow in your nurture and admonition, that he may bring glory to you and serve others in your name. Lord, in your mercy, O Father of lights, by the power of the Holy Spirit, enable us to recognize that we have come to Zion here in the church, and that great in our midst is the Holy One of Israel, even Jesus our Lord. Bring us to the holy altar in repentance and faith, that we would eat his body and drink his blood for the forgiveness of our sins, the strengthening of our faith, and the certainty of our eternal salvation. Lord, in your mercy, Father of lights, sustain us in our sojourn through this changing world, and bring us together with all your saints to the unchanging life in your eternal kingdom, where you live and reign with your Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. The true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and bore the sins of the world. By his dying he has destroyed death, and by his rising again he has restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with all the saints on earth and hosts of heaven, we praise your holy name and join their glorious song. God, endless is your mercy and eternal is your reign. Out of love you created us and everything which exists. In mercy you preserved the church in Noah's day with a flood. In grace you promised to bless us through Abraham's seed. With patience you protected that seed through the judges and kings of Israel. In faithfulness, you repeated your promises through the prophets. And when the time had fully come, you sent your Son, born of a woman, born under law, to redeem those under law. With a perfect and sufficient sacrifice which paid the price for the sins of the entire world.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. In the same way also he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.
Therefore, gracious Lord, we bow before you in thankfulness for your many and varied gifts. For Christ's redemptive death, his victorious resurrection, his ascension promises, and his powerful reign at your right hand. Bolstered by your endless grace and Pentecost Spirit, we eagerly await his glorious return. Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
God the Father, source of all goodness, in your loving kindness you sent your Son to share our humanity. We thank you that through him you have given us pardon and peace in this sacrament. We also pray that you will not forsake us, but will rule our hearts and minds by your Holy Spirit, so that we willingly serve you day after day. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. This morning is our quarterly congregational meeting, which you are all invited to stay and hear an update on.